Hello, everyone. It is Tuesday, August 20th in the year of our Lord 2013. How are all you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. It's two for Tuesday. You know what that means. Two babes, two hunks, two songs, and two beers for this guy. Because you know beer is good for you. Folks, let's bring out our unofficial sponsor of today's show, the lovely Candace Bowington and her wonderful home business, Stitched by CB. Folks, if you're interested in stitch work, this is your resident expert right here. She's living in New Mexico with her wonderful lesser half, Joey the Bull. He's a spy chasing son of a gun. I worked with him in jolly old England. Very good friends of mine. She watches the show whenever possible. And Candace, you need to promote my page. I will promote your page tonight, okay? Stitched by CB. Check them out as part of our likes for our Beer and Song of the Day Facebook page, which is, by the way, up to 691 likes again. Somebody dropped off. Why? I don't know. Some people, I guess, you know, they have a brain aneurysm or something. Or they get infection of the brain and they lose brain cells and like, delete. Hell, I don't know. Or they deleted their Facebook. Shit, who knows? But either way, who gives a shit, right? Screw them. But anyway, hang on a second. Because you know beer is good for you. Folks, today it's all about American originals and classic hunks and babes and some good music. Today's first beer of the day. This is truly an American original. The oldest brewery in America since 1829. If you're from Pennsylvania, you know what I'm talking about. Here on Yuengling Lager. Great stuff out of Pottsville, Pennsylvania. 5% average strength, if I'm not mistaken. 45-degree angle. Beer. Wait a minute. I thought this was a green bottle. Oh, it is. Ha! I'm wearing 3D sunglasses. This is the only green bottle beer I know that does not have that skunky smell or aftertaste to it. With the exception of those really dark Belgian fruit beers. Proud beer opening apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. No skunkiness whatsoever. Hey, how about a proper beer consumption apparatus? 45-degree angle right to the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Okay, I get it. I'm using a goblet with a Yuengling. There's a reason for this. My other beer recommends a goblet, and I am not going to piss my wife off and drink out of two different beer consumption apparatuses, okay? Cheers and beers to all you prostitutes, they say in Germany, kapai, as they say in Japan. Tell you what, that's a B+. Probably the best damn lager I've ever had, okay? Possibly. No, I lied. Sam Adams Boston Lager I like better. I lied. But this is among the best I've ever had for lagers. I'm not a big lager guy or an ale guy. No, I like my stouts, porters, and my fruit beers and stuff like that. And things of that nature. And, of course, my Belgian beers and my Hefeweizens out of Germany. All right, folks, let's get cracking, y'all. Happy birthday to my man, Mark Sweeney. A fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Regional High School class of 1987. He graduated with my brother's better half, Melissa Reynolds, now Baker, as she's been for almost 14 years. Mark, how you doing? Hope you're doing well. I know you talk to one of our unofficial sponsors all the time, our good friend, Crystal Lloyd Dozani of Crystal Addiction. You're one of her biggest fans, as am I. Excuse me. And Mike, thank you so much for supporting my friend. I appreciate that. Spreading the word about her page, chiming in. Hey, gotta respect that. Mike, you're a hell of a guy. A wicked awesome vineyard for sure. And hey, cheers and beers to you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, here's a guy I've yet to meet in person. He's a recent add to the Facebook. Thank you, Mafia Wars. Conrad, is it Dennis or Denise? D-E-N-I-S. James. Now, in France, it's Denis, okay, in French. But I know most of you, je ne parle pas français très bien, eh? Ah, that's right. I don't speak French very well, and I'm sure you don't either. But anyway, Conrad is from Northern England. And Conrad's an awesome guy and a big help on the Mafia Wars. Thank you for the ad. Hope you're doing well. Happy birthday, mate. Cheers. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Next on the list. Here's a good Canadian man right here, eh? That's what I'm talking about. Dan Coot. Dan Coot, happy birthday to you, my friend. He's been in the Mafia Wars for about a year with me. And Dan, always helping me out. I appreciate that. Hope you have a happy birthday. Celebrate well and enjoy. Joyeux anniversaire. Anniversaire. Something like that. Trying to speak a little French here, you know. But hey, have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Or as they say in French, méchant génial. That's French for wicked awesome. All right. And then we got my man Ray Lepard. A badass crew dog. Yeah, I worked with in good old Japan, a great place indeed. Ray, I hope I get this right. Oklahoma man, right? Northern Texas? I'm just kidding. I'm busting your chops. Oklahoma, a fine, outstanding state indeed. And Ray, if I remember, you are a big-time Sooners fan. Miss the hell out of you. Hope you're having a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well. Enjoy. Big cheers and beers to your brother. Hope you enjoy the show. That's it for the birthdays, folks. Let's get those trivia questions out of the way. And before I do that, I want you all to know. Remember yesterday I was looking for that Jonathan Frakes fact that our good male administrator, one big, McLarge, huge, worked extensively to find to bring to you. Well, I put it right on the paper, right on my show notes as soon as I got downstairs and on the computer. After dinner, of course. And that spicy sausage jambalaya last night was phenomenal. Tonight for dinner, chili relleno, baby. Mmm. Oh, yeah, with those Hatch New Mexico chili peppers. Oh, yes, buddy. I'm so spoiled. All right, folks, here it is. Jonathan Scott Frakes got his break when he was cast as William T. Riker. He even got a TV term named for him, calling growing the Riker beard. Referring to when a TV show starts to basically get its act together. I never knew that. Well, our man Big McLarge Huge, thank you, brother. Thank you for providing that. A Love Doctor salute to my own admin. And you know what? I'm going to give a Love Doctor salute to my lady admin, Gidget. She is helping to bring the classic actors and actresses to you as babes and hunks of the day. She's big into that. I thought I was into the 50s and 60s. Shit, this woman should have been born in 1938 as well, just like me. No doubt. Because we are bringing it, baby. We're bringing it, and you'll see that shortly. All right, trivia questions. The first one was simple. For what game were two Jokers originally included in a standard deck of playing cards? Well, my man Jonathan Hemel, he is a card shark resident expert. He says Euchre, and by God, Jonathan, you nailed it. He's a badass gat god. I worked with a jolly old England. He's living here in Yeehaw, Texas. He's from Louisiana, better known as Eastern Texas. Oh, I won't say Southern Arkansas. Don't worry, Jonathan. I won't degrade you that bad. But Jonathan is a legend of a man. And Jonathan, wicked awesome job, brother. A Love Doctor salute to you. Hey, when are you going to come over for dinner again, huh? You're always welcome and, you know, you never imply. It's always us saying, bring your ass over for dinner. You're always welcome here, Jonathan. Bring the kids. Hell of a guy. Very good friend of mine. Cheers and beers. And then the other trivia question. What is a shadow clock? Oh, our man Jeff Hoppy Hopkins. He's a semi-pro professional offensive tackle, if I'm not mistaken. Offensive or defensive tackle? Probably both. This guy's that awesome. And a wicked hardcore Denver Broncos fan. This guy's a wicked hardcore Colorado sports fan all the way. I can promise you that. I've never met the guy, and I hope I do, Hoppy. I really do. You're a phenomenal guy. We've been talking on sports chat message boards for years. And he says, to prove that he's not just a sports guy, he says a sundial. It uses the shadow from a thing in the middle as the hands on a clock showing the hour. Dude, you freaking nailed it. Wicked awesome job, Hoppy. Hell yeah. Hey, Nuggets, Avalanche, Rockies, Broncos. Some good teams right there. Colorado, phenomenal beer, and I'll be bringing one for you next after I drink this here beer. Hey, Love Doctor, salute to you, Hoppy. Phenomenal job, man. Way to go, brother. All right. How about some additional shout-outs real quick? I got time. Let's give a shout-out to a weapons badass. This guy fixes weapons for a living. And we're also going to give a shout-out to his better half, Jasmine. Orlando and Jasmine Chavez. They work here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. And Jasmine fixes engines. He fixes weapons. These folks, obviously good with their hands. No doubt about that. Mechanically inclined. Or is she womanically inclined? Hell, I don't know. But I wanted to give the Chavez's some love from the Love Doctor himself. I told you, Orlando, I was going to hook you up. Hook up your better half as well. You guys are phenomenal, great folks. And I say cheers and beers to the two of you. Have a wicked awesome day and enjoy the show, will ya? Hell yeah. Let's give a shout out to a man, a wonderful young man. He's moving. He's a spike-chasing legend of a man. A very good friend of mine. Quiet, unassuming dude. Very down-to-earth. Hard worker. Andrew Smith. A phenomenal man that is moving to jolly old England. My old stomping grounds. Brother, I'll tell you what, man. Andrew, let me... Seriously. You need anything. I got you covered like a blanket. And hey, do me a favor. Make sure you go out... I know you're working in a different area. Look for the building that's numbered 848, okay? And look for a plaque. And it will say, the Reverend Dr. Joshua S. Baker Lung Slayer Lounge. Yes, I have a building named after me. If that ain't awesome, I don't know what is. Squeeze me. Yikes. Ah, I had to get that one out of my system. Yeah, more room for more beer. Hell yeah. Let's shove it on down here. And Andrew, seriously, Laxfield, remember that. King's Head, I think it was called, if I'm not mistaken. I showed you it earlier today at work. Get your ass over to that Laxfield pub. 14th, 15th century. I think it was 15th century, 1400s it was built. You have got to get your ass along with the rest of you over there. All right? Laxfield, Laxfield. Folks, if you're in jolly old England, get your ass over to that pub. I promise you, I loved it there. Oh, I'd go back again in a heartbeat. And finally, how about a shout out to another weapon-fixing badass son of a gun, my man, Mike Finch. Hey, he's a Finch, not a Fink, all right? Mike, hell of a guy. Dude, great hanging out with you today. Phenomenal young man. Ultra cool, wicked awesome, and dude, I'm still looking for that Asahi. I gotta get some Asahi busted out on the show for you. I can get Sapporo beer, but I gotta get some Asahi. I prefer some Asahi Dark. See, him and I have both lived in Japan, and it's a wonderful country indeed, isn't it? Hell yeah, Coco Ichiban. I want my level 2 chicken curry cutlet level 2 with cheese. I don't need any higher than that. I've had a 4. And, dude, ain't no point in going to level 10. You want to taste your food, you know? Level 2, decent spice. I probably prefer level 4, actually, now I think of it, because I'm a spicy individual. Hey, what do you expect? I'm married to the limb goddess. You gotta get hot and spicy. Otherwise, you're worthless as tits on a boar. Well, the Love Doctor ain't worthless as tits on a boar, I can promise you that. And Mike Finch, I know you're not either. Dude, we're gonna hang out sometime, all right? Hey, Mike, I want you as a future guest co-host on this here show, all right? God hates coward. Bring your ass along with the rest of you. Bring your ass over to the Love Goddess's Love Palace. And we'll share a beer. And we'll entertain the world. Cheers the beers, Mike. Hell of a freaking guy. With that said, I think it's time we bring out... I got something special, folks. I got something special up my sleeve. I was thinking about it when we decided to have this man. Oh, shit. I almost forgot to give a shout-out. This guy requested. I got a spark-chasing badass legend friend of mine that I worked with in jolly old England, Jason Noop. He requested this man a long time ago. Ask and you shall receive. Hey, It may not be Fan Appreciation Week anymore, officially. However, every day on Beer and Song of the Day, our admins, and yours truly, the Love Doctor, we always appreciate our fans. And we are continuing, excuse me, to grant those fan requests. And if you want something on the show, you let us know. Just chime in on our page. The more active you are as a fan, the better chance you have of becoming Fan of the Week. Just ask Renee Phillips, 3-time Fan of the Week. She is actively involved and shares the show every day. That is wicked awesome. Well, my good man, Jason Noop. This guy's a legend of a man, a badass spike chasing son of a gun. Kind of eccentric, a smart guy. He ain't afraid to tell it like it is. Well, I'll tell you what. You want him, and you got him. And for you, Jason, we love the movie The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. So I'm going to bring out a song from that. This is the same guy that did the Godfather theme, Ennio Morricone. Morricone, or is it Morricone? Hell, I don't know. Ecstasy of Gold. Folks, let me pump up the volume on this a little bit, huh? As we show up, 83-year-old legend. I can't believe he's 83. I'll bet you he'll still beat the shit out of most people. That's right. Go ahead. Make my day. We've been talking about the one and the only Clint Eastwood. And remember when Marty McFly used the name Clint Eastwood in Back to the Future? Look at this. Look at Clint Eastwood back in the day. Who knew, right? You always think of him as a tough, grizzled old veteran. He was quite the dapper man back in the day, folks. I'm telling you. He was a bay magnet. Now, I don't know about you, but a lot of people, including yours, truly remember him like that. You didn't mess with this man. He'd screw your world up. Even today, he'll screw your world up. I can't believe he's 83 years old. He's been acting for like 60 years, folks. Clint Eastwood. Wow, look at this, will you? I don't know about pointing a gun to you. It's not very smart, but Clint Eastwood. What are you going to do? Tell him no? And he'll tell you. You know what Clint Eastwood would do to you if you told him no? He'd probably give you a big fat GFY. You don't mess with Clint Eastwood. There you go, folks. That's pretty badass right there. A handsome man indeed. Oh, and he's got a life. And of course, now, remember, Orlando, I told you earlier today, I had the luck of a murder victim on electronic devices. I wasn't bullshitting you, brother. I wasn't bullshitting you. The Love Doctor has the luck of a murder victim on electronic devices, period. End of freaking story. Get back to some Clint Eastwood, will you, huh? I'll tell you what, those Dirty Harry movies, he had 5 of them, and they were all phenomenal. My father's a huge fan of Clint Eastwood as well. And I think most people in the world are a fan of this legend. Didn't know he was such a dapper young man, did you? Now you do. Amazing. Kelly Floyd, way to go. She grabs all your hunk of the day pictures. She is here for you, the fan, and she helps me out. Saves a lot of time by her grabbing the pictures and emailing them to me. As my man Big McLeod, Justin Dimmitt, he grabs all the babe of the day pictures and emails them to me. Without my admins, I'm as worthless as tits on a board, folks. I'm telling you. Look at that. That's how we remember Clint Eastwood, though. At least I do. This dude didn't give a shit about nobody. He screwed you up. He ruined your world. Bang. Wow. And you know something? He's got some hot daughters too. I'll tell you. How's that for it? That's a telephone in case you're a kid and don't realize what that contraption is. That is an actual telephone. It's a payphone. You used to have to put a dime in there to make a phone call. Yeah, some people don't know that concept, I'm telling you. Then again, these are the same type of people that have never heard of George Carlin either, so. And we'll get to that in a moment. That's right. Legend. Badass. Wicked awesome. Clint Eastwood. Alright. I think that's it for our Clint Eastwood pictures. Let's draw some celebrity birthdays real quick, huh? On this day in 1992, she's 21 years old. She's finer than a new set of snow tires, stunningly gorgeous. Demi Lovato. That's right. Not Demi Moore. Demi Lovato. Check her out. L-O-V-A-T-O. Good God. Stunningly gorgeous. Not a bad singer either. I'm not into that modern music. Hey, something I am into that's modern, though. This is kind of our cult classic beer that everybody loves, including the Love Doctor. Oh, yeah. Like I told you, Hoppy, got to represent Colorado. New Belgium Fat Tire Ale. That's right. Fat Tire Amber Ale. 5.2% of absolute exquisite awesomeness. I don't even have to look at the percentage. I've got this one memorized. I've drank a lot of these. And see that? Look at that. New Belgium Brewing Company. They tell you optimum temperature to serve 45 degrees. They show you what type of beer consumption apparatus to serve it in. New Belgium Brewing Company, I'm telling you, they are amazing. See, in Belgium, beer drinking is not just something you do. It is a work of art. Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. Voila. And, of course, as always, 45 degree angle right into the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet on the keyboard. Never have, never will. I've proven it to you. I've even done this blindfolded. All right. Cheers and beers to all you prosses in Germany. Goodbye, as they say in Japan. God, I love this beer. Oh, my God. I think I usually rate that an A-. I can't remember anymore. A- on the Love Doctor's scale of beer rating ability, yeah? Hey, remember, some people, that's their favorite beer. The Love Doctor, I'm like, hey, there's better out there, in my opinion. But what I like and what you like are different. Thank God we have the freedom to be different. All right, Amy Adams, actress. She's 39 and still pretty damn fine. Robert Plant. Here you go, folks. You better know who Robert Plant is if you're into classic rock or rock music, heavy metal. That's right. Led Zeppelin vocalist, songwriter, legend. Senior citizen today. Folks, Rolling Stone magazine actually rated him as the number one vocalist of all time. I don't know about that personally. I think the guy's phenomenal. But number one all time? Dude, did they not listen to like Johnny Mathis or Willie Winfield, of the lead singer of the doo-wop group, the Harptones, or Rudy West, lead singer of the Five Keys, another phenomenal doo-wop group? Both these guys. I mean, Jackie Wilson? Good Lord. Sam Cooke? Barry White? Marvin Gaye? Isaac Hayes? Good Lord! And they gave Robert Plant, number one vocalist of all time. Remember, Rolling Stone magazine is the same schmucks and schmuckas that came out with that cover honoring a terrorist. That's right. So, you know what? While I got a moment, I know I'm going to add a minute or two to the show, but Rolling Stone magazine, yeah. I trust their opinion. Sure. You know what? I trust their opinion like I would trust a priest telling me how to pick a woman. Really? Come on. Just saying. I'm not trying to dog priests, okay? You know, you go to the subject matter expert. Rolling Stone ain't no subject matter expert. Remember that bullshit right there? Yeah. That guy got a lot of fame because of that. Well, you know what, Rolling Stone magazine? You still get that. However, Rolling Stone magazine, if you had done a cover like that, and that is not an official cover, by the way. There was a designer out there that made that cover. If they had done that, they'd have gotten the Love Doctor salute. But they didn't, so they get the GFY instead. All right, enough of the negativity. Let's get to some positive stuff. Robert Plant, badass. Kurt Cobain's rapper, 24 years old today. Speaking of the late, great Isaac Hayes, remember him, Chef, in South Park? By the way, he also sang the 1971 theme classic, Shaft. Damn right. Born this day, 1942, passed away 2008. God, I miss Isaac Hayes. He was a legend indeed. Another one that we missed big time. Remember the late, great Dimebag Darrell Abbott? Dimebag Darrell, that's right. A legend with Pantera. Dimebag Darrell, born this day, 1966. Murdered by a deranged fan in 2004. That is sad. That is tragic. He didn't die from drugs. He didn't die from life on the road. Didn't die from alcoholism. He died because some douchebag cocksucker out there murdered him. Ugh! A real sad loss. Pantera, one of my favorite death metal bands of all time. Dimebag Darrell, I tribute. Definitely miss you. That's right. Dimebag Darrell, baby. We did a special on him a while back. Check out some of my Thrash Metal Thursday episodes, will you? Al Roker! That's right! The famous weatherman, Al Roker, 59 years old. How about Ron Paul? I had no idea he was this old. Ron Paul, three-time presidential candidate. He is 78 years old today. Holy shit. Yeah, he's aged pretty well. I gotta give him that. Fred Durst, that's right, lead singer of Limp Bizkit. He's 43 today. Seems like he's been around forever. Don King, yeah, he's been around forever. Don King, the one that everybody says ruined boxing. Hey, love him or hate him, the guy's a genius. I gotta give him that. You know, he has generated a lot of money in boxing. And I still think the guy's a fruitcake, but give him credit where credit's due. He's a genius. He's also got the most wild hair I've ever seen. 82 years old today. Don King still going strong. Connie Chung, famous for CBS Evening News. Connie Chung, 67 years old today. 23rd President of the United States of America, who most people probably don't know because they don't teach this shit anymore in school. Benjamin Harrison, that's right, the grandson of the 9th President of the United States of America, William Henry Harrison. Benjamin Harrison, born in the state in 1833, passed away in 1901. Todd Helton, I know Hoppy knows about this guy. Todd Helton, milestone birthday, 40 years old today. And then, Hall of Fame catcher and manager, lived a long damn time. The late, great Al Lopez, born on this day in 1908, passed away at the age of 97 in 2005. Awesome. Love it. I'll drink to that. All right, let's bring out our first babe of the day. And oh, have I got a song for you. See, I want to give some love to the late, great James Brown, the hardest working man in show business. That's right. This guy, badass. And of course, this is the standard that this is the song that everybody's familiar with. It's probably his most famous song of all time. Of course, that could be debatable. I got you. I feel good. Oh, yeah. If I could scream like James Brown, I'll tell you what, I'd have a new job. James Brown, I got you. I feel good. 1965. And this woman will make you feel good. We're talking about, ooh, baby, Tina Louise.
Well, who's that love doctor?
Simple. Ginger. Gilligan's Island, of course. She'll make you feel good. That Gilligan's Island was on while this song was recorded and released. Excuse me. So good. I got you. Ginger. Tina Louise, born February 11, 1934. Still going strong, 79 years old. She got some risque pictures, y'all. Johnny, careful! It is see-through. Oh shit, I showed titties on the show. What are they gonna do, arrest me? Rodney Kennington's got the famous song, Show 'em to Me, and they showed bare boobies. I have never showed bare breastises on this here show before. And they weren't bare, so bare. Take that, Facebook and YouTube. I've had a YouTube account since December 28, 2006. Let's hope they don't ban me for that, okay? We'll see. It was see-through. It was not topless. I don't know, folks. What do you think? I think women have the right to be topless just like men. Besides, some men have big-ass moves that are bigger than a woman's boobs. Ooh, cleavage. Ginger from Gilligan's Island. Definitely smoking hot. I feel nice. Sugar and spice. So nice. So nice. I got it here. Wow, I feel good. I knew that I was. Oh, nothing like a woman with a gun. Nothing like a woman with a weapon, huh? Ah, my weapons friends. That's right, you work on these and so does she. Aha. So good. So good. I got it you. Ah. So good. So good. I got it you. So good. So good. I got it you. Remember, James Brown wrote that shit, y'all. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll out a few this day in history. On this day in 1994, 109.8 degrees Fahrenheit, 43.2 Celsius in Cordoba, Spain. Wow, wicked hot. On this day in 1991, Estonia declared its independence from the Soviet Union. Congratulations. On this day in 1986, mail carrier Patrick Sherrill. Out of Edmond, Oklahoma, shot 14 fellow workers dead. I think that is where the term going postal came from. Folks, I need you to fan to do me a favor, okay? Whoever researches the fact of who the actual, where the term going postal came from and who it's named after, if I want you to prove and post it on our beer page or on the YouTube, on my Red Bow Sox account on YouTube. Either or, do me a favor. You post it. Or even post on my personal page. Say, hey, this is where the term going postal came from. You post it, you will get a special Love Doctor salute on tomorrow's show with a Love Doctor salute and everything, okay? So, get involved. That's right. On this day in 1980, Mount Everest climbed by Italian Reinhold Messner. He climbed it alone. Well, that's pretty freaking stupid in my opinion. Jeez. So how do we know he did it? What kind of proof did he have? He did it alone. Maybe he went 14,000 feet instead of 29,028 feet. On this day also in 1980, New York Yankee Bob Watson. He hits the Seattle Kingdom speaker for the second straight day. Maybe that's part of the reason why the Seattle Kingdom was blown the hell up. Because the roof was too low. The roof is on fire. Good, I couldn't help it. Hey, the day that Amy Adams, actress, was born in 1974, Brooklyn pitcher Dan Bankhead is... Brooklyn pitcher? What the hell are they talking about? They didn't have a Brooklyn... I'm thinking it's the Dodgers. They screwed that one up. Dan Bankhead... Well, I BrainyHistory.com gets a little GFY. They cornholed me, and not pleasurably either. Well, Dan Bankhead, first black player to homer in his very first at-bat in the major leagues. A pitcher, too. That's pretty badass. On this day, 1969, 69 centimeters of rainfall. That's over 2 feet. It fell in Nelson County, Virginia, a state record. On his day in 1967, Alvin Dark, listen to this one. Alvin Dark, with a record of 52-69, is fired, rehired, and fired again as the manager of the Kansas City A's, who moved to Oakland the year later. On his day in 1960, Senegal breaks from Mali Federation. Happy Independence Day to the country of Senegal. With that said, What I want to do is I want to go ahead and bring out, this is a long one, and it's from the hardest working man in show business. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring out our other hunk of the day, and then I'm going to bring out our other babe of the day. Our other hunk of the day, as soon as my phone cooperates with me, there you go. You're going to have one legend. You're going to have another. Morgan Freeman. That's right. I loved him in Shawshank Redemption as Red. I love Shawshank Redemption. It's one of my top 10 favorite movies of all time. Morgan Freeman, phenomenal actor, 76 years old. And what's funny is there's so many rumors out there that he's dead. Folks, he is not dead. He is alive and well and doing great. Morgan Freeman, BMF all the way, bad mofo. I wouldn't mess with this guy. It would be ass. Morgan Freeman, ultra cool, wicked awesome. And I think he would be a great narrator, too. I really do. But anyway, let's bring out a six-minute badass song. My personal favorite by James Brown from 1970. Folks, just listen. All I'm going to do is I'm going to show pictures of the great Morgan Freeman. And then I will mention our other babe of the day who's finer than Tina Louise. I promise you, in my opinion, she is, and I think you'll agree with me on that. And you just kick back and listen to how the hardest working man in show business, the godfather of soul, why he was called that. Listen to the screams. It's insane in the membrane. Give it up and turn it loose, 1970, James Brown. And remember, like Eddie Murphy said, James Brown wrote this shit, y'all. He wrote this shit. All those.
God,
God,
what are you?
I'm feeling funky. Don't forget those bands that these funk musicians have. Funk music, phenomenal. There we go. That's the air, baby, right there. Big hair, the afro, the most phenomenal hairdo ever. Men and women of all races wore it. That's right. And James Brown agrees about that shit. Most universal hairdo ever. Principal Joe Clark, Fairy Side High, 1989, Lean on Me. I love that movie, folks. Love it. They used to call me Crazy Joe, now they call me Batman. Great movie, I highly recommend it. Wow, look at that. Morgan Freeman. Morgan Freeman was in the United States Air Force, apparently. I never knew that. Much respect. Those that helped preserve my freedom to do a show for you. Oh, nothing but the utmost respect, y'all. All right, folks. It is time to bring out an absolute exquisite hottie. Hell, you thought Ginger was hot? Squeeze me. Oh, she was hot indeed. But I always felt this woe man was even hotter. Wicked hotter. So sweet and innocent. Don Wells, Marianne. That's right. Gilligan's Island as well. There you go. I believe I did not verificate the facts. Verificate as opposed to defecate. I did not verificate the facts, but I do believe she was born in 1941. Shit, before Daisy Duke, she had those. And James Brown agrees on that shit, y'all. That's her later on. She has aged incredibly. That's what I'm talking about. James Brown knows what's up, y'all. He knows what's up. He knows how fine this woman is. He knows it. James Brown wrote this shit. Don Wells. Oh, dear Lord. I like that. I think y'all like that, too. Shit, that'll make a straight woman go lesbian right there, yo. She's so sweet and innocent. And I know some of you youngins out there getting taught a lesson right now. Women have always been fine, okay? You just don't realize that. That's what the Love Doctor's here to do. We're here to show that there's been beauty around since long before we were brought onto this here earth. Yeah, I'll clap them hands. Look at that hat, will ya? People have called me Gilligan for years, okay? I shouldn't have let that out, but it's true. A lot of people call me Gilligan. Hey, little buddy. And I know my admins went through hell to find these pictures. Yeah, let's spin the phone that way and make the picture bigger, will ya? How did I miss this Clint Eastwood picture? I skipped over that Clint Eastwood picture, apparently. I think. There you go. In case I missed them. Oh, no, I didn't. That's all right. Hey, a little extra Clint for ya. Yeah, I almost said something else. I almost forgot the end. Alrighty. Hell yeah. Well, let's bring out the final this day in history. On this day in 1958, Dale Long becomes the first Major League left-handed catcher in 52 years. Wow. Dale Long, the same Dale Long that hit 8 home runs. He hit a home run every day for 8 days straight. Wow, that was back in 1956. Don Mattingly tied that record years later. On this day, 1957, U.S. Air Force balloon breaks an altitude record at 102,000 feet. Holy shitballs. On this day, 1955, the first airplane to exceed 1,800 miles per hour, H.A. Haynes, Palmdale, California, the land of fruits and nuts. On this day, 1945, Tommy Brown, Brooklyn Dodger, becomes the youngest home run hitter ever. He was 17 years old. Pretty badass. On this day, 1938, Lou Gehrig, that's right, Yankee legend, Iron Horse, hits his final and record, and that record still stands 75 years later today. 23rd Grand Slam. Lou Gehrig, he wasn't just a disease, folks. He was an amazing baseball player. Telling you. New York Yankees legend, class act all the way. On this day, 1930, Dumont's first television broadcast for home reception. Where at? New York City. Yippers. 1930. Wow. On this day, 1929, the first airship flight around Earth began flying eastward, completed. Yep, they flew around the world, heading east. First time ever, 1929. On this day, 1925, WJR AM Radio, Detroit, Michigan, begins radio transmissions. On this day, 1920, the first United States commercial radio, 8 megawatts, WWJ Radio, Detroit, Michigan, begins broadcasting. On this day, also in 1920, preliminary meeting in Akron, Ohio, to form the American Pro Football League, baby, National Football League. That's why Akron, Ohio is the NFL Hall of Fame. That's where it all started. 93 years ago today. On this day in 1919, Wichita outfielder, listen to this one, Joe Wilhoit of the Western League, minor leagues, fails to get a hit, but ended a 69-game hitting streak. He had 155 hits and 299 at-bats for a .505 batting average. If you're a baseball fan, that, you understand, is truly wicked awesome. On this day, 100 years ago today, in 1913, the first pilot to parachute from an aircraft, Adolphe Pigoud of France. Yeah, I mentioned that yesterday. Apparently, it was on this day, but yeah, whatever. You know, time zone difference. On this day in 1908, Congo Free State becomes Belgian Congo. Yay! Congratulations on the name change. Hey, check this out. On this day in 1896, the dial telephone was patented. On this day in 1893, Shishita, better known as ritual slaughtering, is prohibited in Switzerland. Aw, bummer! No more ritual slaughtering! On this day in 1882, Tchaikovsky's ever-famous 1812 Overture opened in Moscow. There you go, classical music fans. On this day in 1866, President Andrew Johnson, probably the worst president in the history of the United States, formally declares the Civil War over. Well, that's the one good thing he did in life. On this day in 1856, Wilberforce University forms in Ohio. Never heard of it. On this day in 1741, Alaska discovered by Danish explorer Vitus Bering, who, by the way, died later that year. Kind of sad, but true. On this day in 1619, love it or hate it, folks, but the first black slaves were brought by the Dutch to the colony of Jamestown, Virginia. And, you know, though the slave trade was definitely bullshit, I am thankful that we, as Americans, represent more races than probably anywhere else in the world. I love it. I have variety is the spice of life. I judge by people by who they are, not what they look like, okay? And that's the way it is. Much respect to all races, male and female. Racism is just plain freaking stupid, all right? There you go. That's how I feel about it. And finally, on this day in the year 2, that's right, Venus and Jupiter were in conjunction with the star of Bethlehem. If you're a Christian like me, you understand how important that is, okay? They say that the Lord Jesus Christ was born in the year 4 BC and passed away. Every source I've read says he died 30 AD. We know he was crucified, all that stuff. And, yeah, so there you go. He was only, 6 years old then. So if you're a Christian, you understand how important that is. If you're not a Christian, my apologies. Like I say, I judge everybody by who they are, not what they look like, not what religion, not what sexuality, not what faith, not anything. Sexual preference? Hey, it's up to you. I judge by you, who you are. And with that, I drink to that, folks. If you're awesome and totally wicked awesome, I salute. I don't care what your belief is or what you look like. Empty is the brain cells of an average Yankee fan. Folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make a fetus to head out so everybody take a cab. Wicked awesome night and day. Peace be the journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive my spray drink. I might kill yourself or somebody else and drink and drive is dumb as being a Yankees fan and what's dumb as that. It's root for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli.
Ow, I'm as good as Tom Brady.
Yeah, your friggin' dreams. Manning! Or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people that welch on bets, or anybody that supports the Fens, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. things like that are just plain stupid and definitely deserve a big fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. By the way, the smell of burnt nose hairs, it sucks.